Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the next question. Okay, so this question belongs to GATE CSC 2006. The question is, consider the circuit above. So they gave a circuit. Which one of the following option correctly represents the value of F? Okay, so this is a direct multiplexer question, right? So let us start solving it. Okay, so it is a 2 cross 1 multiplexer. So let us write the characteristic equation for this and find the result here. Okay, so X Y bar into the input is, the select line is a Z. So Z bar Z plus. There is no concept of enable line. So this will be the result. So it is a nothing but X Z bar plus Y bar Z, right? Yes. So let me write it here so that it will be a clear for us. Okay. So let us solve the second part now. The second mux will take this as an one input. Okay. And the other input is directly X. And the select line for this is a Y bar and for this is a Y, right?
Yes.
So let us add them and let us multiply them interiorly. So that will be the result, right? Yes. So this is a nothing but X Y bar Z bar plus Y bar Z plus X Y. So let us cross check. Is there any option like this, guys? Okay. So let us cross check, guys. Or let us check whether did we do any kind of silly mistake here. So there are only two options, right? Yes. Okay. Okay, so according to me, there are no option based on our requirement, guys. So let us try to compress the equation. So I think there is some other minimized expression. So that is given in the option. So I am having the doubt. So let us check it. So X, Y and Z. So X, Y, X, Y, X, Y, X, Y, Z, Z bar, double bar, bar and bar, right? Yes. So now comparing. So X, okay. So X is in these two columns. X, Y bar, Z. So this one. Okay, Y bar Z. So Y bar means these both guys and Z means these two guys. So these two guys. Similarly, XY. So XY means this whole thing will be coming. Okay, yes. So now if you observe, so now our equation is more compressed, right? So you can make these four into one piece. Okay, and you can take these two as one piece, right? So you will be getting only two terms, but here every option is having three terms. So now I understood that these are not compressed equations at all. So now our goal is to find which equation is matching our exact requirement. Okay. So option A says that X Z bar. Okay. So X Z bar means these two guys. Okay. So these two guys are covered by option A already. And the second option says, second part is says is X Y. So these two guys, it is also okay. And the last thing says is Y bar Z. So these two guys. So I think option A is exactly covering our requirement. Okay. Moving on to option B. Okay, so in option B, there is a complement part. So let us first solve it, guys. So Y plus Z whole bar, that is nothing but Y bar plus Z bar, right? Yes. So let us solve the second one now. So it is nothing but X Z bar. So X Z bar means again, these two guys are covered first. Nice. And the next is X Z. So these two guys are covered. Coming to the last part, it is saying Y bar means this whole two rows, two columns will be selected, but this column is not having our requirement, right? Hence, with that simple understanding, B is wrong. The same concept is applied in C also. If you observe, this is giving the issue, that is Y bar, this number we don't want, but in option B and C we are getting that, so it's not valid, or that option is absolutely wrong in simple words. Okay, yes. So option D, coming to option D, it is saying XZ. So XZ means it is first covering these two points, so let me round it up from now. Okay, and the next part, X, Y bar. So X, okay, so these two are X and this is Y bar. So it is saying these two guys, okay. And the last part is saying Y bar Z. So Y bar Z means these two guys. But if you observe, this guy has been left out. So hence this option is also wrong. So with that simple conclusion, you can say A is the correct answer. Got it? Yes. It's a direct solving question, guys, on multiplexers. If you understand the logic, you can solve these questions in maximum of 5 minutes, guys. That's it. Any kind of question he might give. Okay? Yes. So now I hope everyone is getting some confidence, right? Yes. So in the next lecture, let us continue with the next question. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Like, share, and subscribe for more awesome videos like this. Thank you.